Hey guys, so today it is Sunday, August 23rd, 2020, and so it is just before 9 o'clock. And so, because I had to dim sum lunch earlier today, and so it kind of threw me off a little bit. And so I am sort of hungry and not really hungry. And so, I decided to order some Chinese food delivery, and so whatever. And so, I got this, tofu thing. And then I got this BBQ pork chop fried rice, and I got this sweet and sour chicken thing. So instead of pork, I ordered chicken. So because it's like my weekend off, so just ordering something easy, just simple, and it is my weekend off, so just treating myself and just like whatever, you know? And so yeah, so. So let's get the show started. This plate of Chinese food looks so hot and fresh and steamy, and the tofu is so fresh, and so I just can't wait to dig in, you guys. All right. So, Sunday dinner, and so just treating myself to some Sunday dinner, and like I said, it's my weekend off, so just treating myself, so whatever. Like, I don't know why I need to make myself excuses to treat myself. And so I just want to dig in when everything is still hot and fresh. You know, I know in the past I've said that I know it's stupid to order fried rice from a restaurant. Like, you can make it at home yourself. But you know, like what I also say is like, I just don't know. Like, I just love the way the restaurant style fried rice, like, probably they use the professional kitchen gear, the professional woks and whatnot to make the fried rice. It is just so much better than homemade fried rice, huh? So this is some sweet and sour chicken. I know, like you guys are probably saying that I am Chinese myself. I should make my own fried rice, but you know, my excuses is that I'm just single and I'm just lazy. And you know, honestly, like if you, the Canadian prices for the groceries and stuff, like if you bought all the fresh items yourself to buy, make it and buy it and just make it yourself at home, like when you buy the groceries, it's really not much difference than ordering from a restaurant. Like the way the Canadian prices are, and the Chinese restaurant makes it way faster than you do. Plus, is that you get it delivered as well, so that's a bonus. So, Uber Eats is kind of weird these days. They say they got some type of promotions or something. It's like a 25% off promotion of some sort. And so it's like they got a delivery fee, and then they got a service fee, and then they forced you to pay tips to the driver. And so after all these fees and yada 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 that they charge, and then it's like the $10 off that they took off for the 25% off. So basically, it is all these fees they make, and then they taken off the fees. That is what the discount is. So basically, you just pay for the price of the food. Does that make sense? So today, I had the dim sum lunch with my cousin. And ever since this corona thing started in March, it's like I've not had fresh, hot dim sum for a long time. So, I am gonna show you the footage of the dim sum here because it is so good. So I just want to show you guys. And so I know some viewers in the US, and so some areas do not have this kind of Chinese food. So you guys are probably don't know what dim sum is. So I'm gonna show it to you guys somewhere here.
So when we were in Cologne,
yummy. How many things did we order? Because before this thing happened with my dad, right? Like, did we order another kind of ha gao too? Gao choy gao?
No.
No? Oh, short memory. Doesn't that dim sum look good, you guys? But you know, I don't know, it's like these days, because they give you an order form and you check off what you want. And it's like they don't even tell you what the prices are on the order form. I just don't even know how much it is. So it is very weird these times, like on a weekend. Like, so far during the phase two of this corona thing, at a Chinese restaurant, I've been to a Chinese restaurant a few times. So basically, they are seating each every other table. And when me and my cousin went there, it is a party of twos that are going. And so they space everybody out at every other table. It is so weird on a weekend in a big city in Calgary. Calgary is like over 1 million people in the city. And we have a pretty large Chinese community here. And so it is so weird to see a Chinese restaurant that is not crowded. It's so weird. So on the order form, it's like they don't really tell us what the prices are. Like, I just don't even know what the prices are. So because I had like the dim sum in the middle of the afternoon, and then now I'm just sort of hungry, but not really hungry. Like, I'm not really sure. Fried rice is good. And this time they did not give any fortune cookie. Last time they did. So like for me, during the times of corona, like I keep on saying, I like to support more of the local restaurants and the restaurants that I like. So hopefully, when things get back to normal, whatever normal is, there's going to be Chinese restaurants left that I like, you know? So that is why I try to support, like, as many Chinese restaurants as I could. So, yeah. So first of all, in this video, like during this times with the situation with my dad's medical situation, I like to thank each of you for everybody for your support, and for everybody for sending the prayer train. And so it just makes me feel so like so much better about myself and about the situation, and it makes me feel so special that I'm a YouTuber and I can connect with people around the world, and so many people is sending my dad prayers, and it just feels so amazing. Like, it is so amazing to know that people from around the world is sending my dad prayers, and so thank you so much. Like, this is an emotionally challenging times for me, and so I am so glad I do YouTube, and I sort of make like an online diary, I guess that's what you should call it. So you guys are basically following my life. It's like whatever, like what, whatever that I want to show you. Just some room temperature water. I choke on the chili pepper. And so over the years of me being on YouTube, and so for my longtime subscribers and the people that comments on my videos daily, you guys been basically following my life story from day one. Like, you guys basically follow the ups and downs of my life story. Even though I think that I live a pretty boring life, but, you know, like, I am so shocked that people are even interested to watch my vlogs. Like, I am just a normal single guy. I am not like a hot muscle, sexy Asian, you know, and people still watches my videos. And so I am so grateful for that. And you guys are basically allowing me to have a platform on YouTube. So I make videos and you guys like listen to whatever I say. So I am so grateful for that. So, because like, medical stuff is like a privacy issue and stuff like that, so I might not be telling you guys every single medical thing that is going on with my dad. So I hope you guys understand that. And my family still doesn't really understand why I do YouTube and stuff, but whatever. So, thank you so much for the prayer train, you guys. So today, so again today, I was looking through the Uber Eats, the choices for delivery. And then it's like, oh my gosh, it's like when I look through it like once every few weeks, it's like, again, I notice quite a lot of the new bubble tea places. It's like, what? I'm like, since when did this bubble tea place open? There's like bubble tea galore everywhere. today when I hang out with my cousin, we were near that area, and so we were near where the Peter's Drive-In is. It is the most popular, like, classic drive-through place in Calgary for burgers and shakes and stuff like that. Everybody, the local people, that's been living in the city as long as I have, everybody knows about it. It is one of the classic fast food restaurants in Calgary. So because I haven't been in that area for so long, and so I was like, me and my cousin was like looking for dessert or something after lunch. And so I was like, I saw somebody carry some Peter's Drive-In cup walking by. I was like, hey, I'm like, are we near Peter's Drive-In here? So that is why I decided to go for milkshake today. So again, it's like during the times of Corona, during the time of pandemic and stuff, like just trying to support like different local restaurants and stuff like that. Just try to spend the money locally. So yeah, like that is one of the things that I'm trying to do as much as I could. So yeah. This tofu is so good. Like this week it's been very hot weather, like every day is over 30 degrees plus, and because in Canada we have very short summers, and so that is really hot weather for us. So that is one of the reasons that I didn't want to cook today. And so today, when I uploaded the vlog, OMG. My weekly vlog was just only a little bit over an hour. And it was like a little bit over 3 gigabytes of data. And then I tried to upload it like normal, like the way I always do. And so I tried like 4 separate times and it would just always be stuck in the middle and it just won't upload. So this is as high tech as my computer knowledge goes. And so I decided to cancel it and I compressed the file again and to make it smaller. So from the 3 gigabyte, it just went to like just under 2 gigabytes of data. So That vlog took like 5 times to try to upload. It was being a pain in the butt. Like, you would think that YouTube is a high-tech computer, like a technology thing, and that 3 gigabytes of data should be okay, no problem. Drives me crazy. So I spent like over 3 hours trying to upload that video. The problems that YouTubers go through, right, you guys? That is as high tech as Kelvin goes, you know? So after I finish this video, I'm probably gonna get more fried rice. This restaurant is really, really fresh and delicious. But, you know, the dim sum restaurant that we went to today, the portions is a little bit smaller. So I like the other place better that me and my family usually goes to, which is like a block away. So yeah, so I usually go to that one. So, but you know, sometimes with like different people, just try the different stuff sometimes. So that is all good. And so just switch it up a bit, you know? And so, yep. So that is it for me today. And so, thank you so much for hanging out with me today. And so, Chinese food delivery. I just did a little bit small order this time. If you guys notice, I only ordered the 3 things because I know I've been a little bit naughty eating out lately. And so, yeah. So, thank you so much for hanging out with me today. And don't forget to check out all my other older videos on my playlist on my channel. And I will see ya in the next one.